Welcome to the web tutorial on accessing and downloading PSID data. To begin, let's go over what you can expect to learn. This tutorial has four parts. We'll begin with an overview of how to register as a data user, followed by an explanation of the data webpage. We will continue with more specific information on the four methods of selecting variables using the PSID's online data center, and we'll end with a demonstration on downloading a sample dataset. We will start on the PSID's homepage, PSID.org. Navigate to the Data tab located on the menu below the PSID banner. This links to the page that explains the different types of data that are available, as well as links to the pages that contain the data and documentation. This tutorial focuses on public use data, which are available in several formats. A separate web tutorial discusses the restricted use data, and another is dedicated to the Family Identification Mapping System tool, or FIMS, also introduced here on the data page. The first paragraph provides a link to the registration form, which must be completed before downloading data for the first time. This short registration form requires some basic information about you, your affiliation, your full email address, which will serve as your username, and a password. You may also indicate if you would like to receive announcements about new PSID data, documentation, and related information, usually 2 to 4 emails per year. After reading and agreeing to the conditions of use, click Submit to initiate your registration. You will then receive an email from PSID with a verification link to complete your registration. Please note if the verification email does not arrive within a few hours, we recommend that you re-register, making sure your email address is entered correctly on the form. Once registered as a PSID data user, you may log in via the data page by clicking on the login link in the upper right-hand corner of the page. Public use data can be downloaded directly from the website in multiple forms. You may download zipped files from the package data page for each year, or you may create customized files using the data center. Let's look at each of these in turn. The first link is to the data center, which allows customized files to be created. We will come back to how to use the data center in a moment. If you click on the link labeled Package Data, you'll see a list for downloading zip files containing main and supplemental study data, early release data, and auxiliary data files. If you click on the Main and Supplemental Studies link, you will see two trees. The tree on the left contains the main study zip files, and the tree on the right contains supplemental study zip files, including the Child Development Supplement, Transition into Adulthood Supplement, and the Disability and Use of Time Supplement. The data are provided in text format, along with read-in files for STATA, SAS, and SPSS. Corresponding codebooks and questionnaires by year are also provided. You may click on and save these files to the location of your choosing. For example, if we open the cross-year individual zip file, we will see the data in text format, the read-in files for STATA, SAS, and SPSS, as well as the corresponding codebook and supporting documentation. Next, the Early Release link takes you to descriptions and download instructions for preliminary release data files. Early release versions of the main PSID and its supplemental studies can be found here before they are released in their final edited formats in the data center or on the main and supplemental studies page. If the early release data table is empty, then all data are currently released in their final form. Finally, the Auxiliary Files page lists files which contain variables that are not included in the data center, most often because their structure does not allow them to be incorporated in that way. The setup of the table is similar to the Early Release Data page, where selecting a file name, for example, Residential Moves Detail Files, produces an explanation of the file, as well as a downloadable zip file containing the data and documentation. By moving back to the data page, the user-generated link brings up a page with programs generated by PSID users. Please note that user assistance is not provided by PSID for these user-generated programs. Next, let's review downloading data from the data center. The data center is especially useful for users who want variables automatically merged from multiple files. We'll start once again on the data webpage. Note that you can also click on the Data Center link in the Quick Link sidebar on the right side of the page. There are 4 available methods for adding variables to your cart. 1, by using the variable search function. 2, by browsing through a cross-year index that lists comparable variables across years. 3, by scrolling through a files list of variables. And 4, by entering a list of variables. In addition, the Previous Carts option will allow you to access and update data carts created at an earlier date. For this exercise, using each of the 4 methods, we will demonstrate how to add the same two family-level variables to a data cart. Age of head for 2013, variable ER53017, and sex of head for 2013, variable ER53018. Note that as of 2017, the term head has been replaced by reference person. However, this change is not retroactive, so we will continue to use head in the rest of this tutorial. Please see the video tutorial, Introduction to the Panel Study of Income Dynamics, if you would like more information about this change. When using the data center, you can choose variables using any combination of the four methods, and they will be added to the same data cart. We also provide guidance on the relative strengths of each approach. We will start with the variable search option. This function can be very useful if you are not sure what is available for a particular topic or keyword. This function allows users to search by variable name, label, question text, and explanation text, as well as to refine the search by year, data type, and codebook section. Start by selecting only PSID family level under data type and 2013 under years. Under section of the codebook, select variable label, and then enter the term age of head in the search box and click search. Among the retrieved results, select the appropriate variable ER53017 and then click add to cart. Repeat this process for the second variable, sex of head. Next, let's use the cross year index. The index is especially useful if you want to use the same variables pulled from multiple years. The cross-year index is organized by file and topic and shows availability of variables across all study years. You may select the same variable over multiple years, either by clicking on each year separately or by clicking the variable box to select all available years. To select the first variable of interest, age of head, open the Family Public Data Index, and then click on the topical node, Demographic, followed by the node, Age. You will see several options for age variables. If you click on the information icon for head, you will see the codebook entries for all of the years that variable, age of head, is available, including the variable ER53017 for 2013. To select this variable, click on the box under the column 2013 in the row, head. To select the second variable, sex of head, open the node sex under the same topical node demographic and click on the information icon for head to confirm the variable number ER53018 for 2013. Select this variable by clicking on the box under the year 2013 in the row head under the node sex. Now that you have selected the two variables of interest, click the Add to Cart button at the top of the page. The third variable selection option is the File option. The File method is most useful if you know the names of the variables you want in your data cart, or if you're looking for just a few variables. For this exercise, the variables we wish to locate are under the PSID Family Level node, followed by PSID Main Family Data, and finally in the year 2013. Scroll down to the numeric order list to find the variables of interest, ER53017 and ER53018. If you double-click on the variable, the codebook entry with additional information opens in a separate window. To add these variables to your cart, use Ctrl-click to highlight both of the variables, and then click the Add to Cart button. The final method of selecting PSID variables is the variable list option. This function is convenient for more advanced data users who know which variables they want to download. Multiple variables may be added to a data cart without searching for each variable separately. In this case, simply type the variables ER53017 and ER53018 into the variable list box, separated by a space or a line break, and then click the Add Variables button below. Correct entries will be added to your data cart. Incorrect entries will be returned in a separate box labeled Invalid Variable List. Now that we have added the variables to our cart, we will finalize the process by viewing our cart and then downloading the dataset from the data center. To view the variables that have been added to your cart, click either on the button labeled Variables Added to Your Cart or the Shopping Cart icon in the above right corner of the page. Clicking on the Expand All option will show you all of the variables you manually added to the cart, as well as identifier variables automatically added to each cart to facilitate linking. To download your data, select the checkout option, which opens the web page for specifying download options. Each dataset comes with a custom codebook in the format of your choice. In this case, select PDF. Next, choose the data output type. You may choose ASCII with read-in statements for SAS, STATA, or SPSS, Excel, DBASE, or a SAS transport file. We will choose ASCII with SAS. The next option, subsetting criteria, allows users to select observations within datasets that meet specific conditions. For example, if you wanted to limit observations in your download so that the heads in your sample were aged 50 to 64, the correct subsetting criteria to add in this section would be open parentheses ER53017 greater than or equal to 50 and ER53017 less than 65. Finally, you can choose to make your data cart publicly available, have links sent to your email, or name your cart. Once you have finished these selections, click Submit. The cart data page then opens, showing a list of files available for download. To complete the download and save the data to your computer, click on the File Download icon. Take note of the path where you've saved the data, as you will need to enter this into the read-in statements in the section labeled Path in brackets. In addition, you will receive statements to create labels for the variables in your dataset, as well as a link to the custom codebook. To save all files with your download, click on the File Download icon. Also provided are recommended links to documentation and questionnaires. These documents provide detail on how questions are asked, in what order, and changes over time. This web tutorial was produced by Nora Insulera and Vicki Friedman in collaboration with the Michigan Center on the Demography of Aging, with funding from the National Institute on Aging. This ends the web tutorial on accessing and downloading PSID data. Comments and questions may be sent to psidhelp@umich.edu.